Have you ever wondered why your photos are blurry? Watch the video, see if I can maybe help you out a little bit. What's up everybody, Sam here. I wanted to kind of go through some of the most recent things I've seen, some of the most easy to fix things, I guess, things that will help you become a better photographer, whether you're experienced or not, and kind of go through the steps in general, become a better photographer for paintball as well. So one of the things I see most often is people posting blurry pictures, things out of focus or just downright blurry in general, missed focus, stuff like that. So I want to teach you how to resolve that, as well as, you know, make your photos better in every way pretty much at that point. So I'll kind of go ahead and get started. This will be short, I promise. The first thing, there are a few ways that your photos can be out of focus. You could just miss focus, you know, your f-stop can be low, stuff like that. I'll kind of go through each one and how to remedy it, and we'll go from there. So the very first thing is you could have just missed focus. Now, what a lot of people do when they first start, they let the camera do all the work. They let it choose the focusing point, they'll choose multi-point autofocus, stuff like that. What I would personally do is make sure you don't have it on that. I would put it on single point autofocus. And the reason for that is because it puts you in control of your pictures. You choose where your camera is supposed to be focusing. If you let the camera choose and you're shooting paintball, it's going to choose a bunker. It's going to choose the ground. It's not really going to choose the person as many times as you'd like it to be. And the time it does, great, but most of the time it won't. And you don't want to leave that to chance. So that's kind of the first thing. The second thing, your shutter speed could be really, really low. Now, say you're at 1/500th of a second. That's fast to, you know, us, but to a camera, that's really slow, especially if someone's diving or sliding, stuff like that. So what I would recommend at the very least is a minimum of 1/1500th of a second. I would go higher, but that's the minimum. You want to freeze the action. If you don't freeze the action, it looks blurry. You don't get people in focus. It's very hard to get things in focus with motion blur if they're moving. Hey guys, so I just want to cut in here and kind of point out what these photos, you know, what changed, so that way you can see. I chose relatively similar photos, but I know they aren't the exact same. One was shot at 1/500th of a second, the other one was shot at 1/3200th of a second. And if you look at her feet, at the very least, everything else does look fine, but her feet, you can see that they are blurry. And the reason for that is because it was shot at 1/500th, whereas the other one, which I will be showing you now, is shot at 1/3200th of a second. It's considerably better. So this is why shooting at a higher shutter speed is important. So, and kind of the final thing is your f-stop. You could be shooting at 2.8, which, you know, it looks fantastic when it hits focus perfectly, but sometimes it just doesn't. So what I would recommend doing is shooting at 3.2 or higher. That changes the focal plane, so it's a bit wider. Instead of it being that big, it's, you know, say that big. And that does help a lot. You want more of them in focus anyway, so it helps regardless, but it's harder to miss. So that's kind of my three tips right there. As I said, it's not going to be a long video. I just wanted to do something that would help the people that needed it. I'll also kind of go through my own settings, because I should, right? So what I do is I use a 1DX Mark II, and I'm in Florida, for those of you that don't know. So it's, things change really fast down here weather-wise. I usually shoot at 1/2000th or higher of a second, f3.2 or higher. I usually don't go any higher than 5.6. That's personal reasons. I don't like the background being so in focus that it's noticeable. I'd rather have at least some out of focus, which is called bokeh. And then I shoot at auto ISO, which is kind of a sin, I guess, to a lot of manual shooters. But I prefer to shoot at auto ISO because, as I said, things change fast in Florida. 1 second it's raining, 1 second it's not. So it's just easier just to let the camera do that and then fix and post. I do limit it, though. I don't let it go any higher than 1/2000. Wow. I don't let it go any higher than 2000 ISO. And that reason is just so I don't have a lot of grain get introduced into the photo. Other than that, as I said, it's going to be a short video. It's like 4 minutes long. I just wanted to kind of put this out there, a little perspective, and help people that might need it. So if you like this, you know, like, subscribe, do all the fun things. And I hope everyone has a great rest of their day.